In the following lesson, we will learn how we can create splines in AutoCAD. In mathematics, a spline is a special function defined piecewise by polynomials. In the computer science subfields of computer-aided design and computer graphics, the term spline more frequently refers to a piecewise polynomial curve. As a computer-aided design application, AutoCAD can create such parametric curves, also known as splines. There are two ways of creating spline curves. The first one is to draw a spline curve which follows certain points, and the second is to draw a spline curve which is intermediate to certain points that basically control the shape of the curve. Those points are also referred to as control points or control vertices. As you can see, a drawing for this purpose has been created, containing some points to help me create the spline curves. Before I activate the tool, I will make sure that the node snap is active, so my cursor will be pulled at the existing points every time I move close to them. The spline tool can be found in both the draw menu and the home ribbon if we click on the arrow of the panel draw to expand it. As we already know, we can also type the word spline in the command line and press enter to activate it. So, to activate the spline tools, I will click on the arrow of the draw panel to expand it, and then I will select the first type of spline, which is Spline Fit. With the tool active, I will start clicking on the points one by one. I will click on the first point to specify the starting point of the spline, and then the next points to gradually create the curve. Every time I click on the next point, another segment of the spline is created. Once I have clicked on the last point, I will press Enter to finish the spline. Notice that a curve that crosses every point I chose has been created. At this point, I will expand the panel draw again, but this time I will select the Spline Control Vertices tool. I will click on the first point again to specify the starting point of the spline, and then I will start clicking on the rest to define every next point. However, as I specify the next points of the spline one by one, the curve that is being created does not coincide with those points. It is being created somewhere in between instead. This happens because the intermediate points play the role of control vertices. And to be more precise, the control vertices define a control frame to shape the spline. Once I have clicked on the last point, I will press Enter. Notice that automatically the end of the curve coincides with the last point I clicked on. At this point, I will type the word spline in the command line to show you how you can switch from spline fit to spline control vertices from there. When the command is active, I can click on the method menu from the command line and change the type from control vertices to fit and vice versa. I will click on the control vertices option to mention something interesting. As I mentioned in the beginning of the lesson, a spline curve is defined by a polynomial function. I can change the degree of the function by clicking on the degree option in the command line. The default degree of the polynomial function used to create the curve is 3. I will set this value as 1. Now I will create another spline using the same control points I used before. When the spline is finished, it is no longer a curve, but a line. You can experiment with the different results of polynomial functions of different degree and decide which one is the best option for you.